everybody. I'm a dog musher in Nome, Alaska, and today I'm going to give you a quick kennel tour. Welcome to the dog yard. This is Deja Vu Sled Dogs. I'm going to tell you a little bit about what we do here. Biggest thing that we do is we go out dog mushing, and we also do other things, like we go hiking, we go canoeing with the dogs, we take them out camping, we go on road trips, we sit on the couch and cuddle. Pretty much anything that you can think of doing with a pet dog, we do with our sled dogs. There are 9 dogs out here right now, hanging out on this beautiful day. Hi, Grayling. So we've got Grayling, Lava. Hi, Lava. And we've got Suki. Hi, Suki. And then we've got over here, Crystal. Good girl, Crystal. Good girl. And Winter. And we've got Copper, big guy. And there's Cobalt in his house. He loves his house. Huh, buddy? Hi. Good boy. Can you come out and say hi? Also loves to give hugs. Good boy. So they're in this. I know, Copper. They're in this fenced yard for a couple of reasons. To allow them some space to run around and play. And also to protect them from muskox. Yeah. Because we're right at the base of this hill here, and there are muskox just normally beyond the hill where we could see them from the house actually the other day. But they don't normally come down here, but they can be really dangerous for dogs. So that's why fences are really important. And this coming summer, we're gonna be expanding the dog yard and making it quite a bit bigger, using some stronger fencing. So the dogs love to hang out here on nice days. They hang out on their houses. They run around and play. Lately though, with the snow, they've been jumping over the fence a lot. So that's why they've got to stay chained up, because otherwise they jump over the fence and then they go run around and play on the tundra. So they spend a lot of time inside too. They've been sleeping inside a lot. So they're all house trained and they love to be inside and sleep on the girl's bed. But they're also really happy out here too. Last night, Crystal right there and Cobalt, he's in his house right now, they didn't want to come inside. So they refused to come inside because it was pretty nice out. And we have that shed over there behind Grayling that will be a dog barn next year. We're gonna clean out and put straw in there and have little houses so when the weather's really bad, especially during the day if we're not home, they can go in there to get some shelter. They've each got a house with fresh straw. Straw is really expensive in Nome. It's about $60 a bale, which is very different than what we're used to in Toke. We would get straw for really, really cheap because we're so close to Delta. They grow a lot of straw there. But here, with the shipping costs, it's about $60 a bale. So it's pretty expensive. But the dogs get fresh straw, and especially when the weather is bad or it's really snowy, we have to replace straw pretty often to make sure that they've got somewhere warm and dry. They always get excited when they get their fresh straw. They don't just live on their chains all the time. They get to come inside, go for runs, go for hikes. So they're pretty happy. Yeah, pretty happy, huh, Grayling? Yeah, you're a good girl. You're a good girl. Yes, you are. All right, I hope you enjoyed the tour, and I'll see you guys later. Bye.